Welcome back to Hogwarts Legacy. I'm BT, and there's the boxes we were stuck in. Fortunately, the game autosaves like every 3 seconds, so all I had to do was load a previous autosave. So now we can go back to exploring. And I think that instead of exploring every little nook and cranny, crevice, crack, we should probably go do some classes. Although, as I say that, there's a door I haven't been in.
Oh. Revelio.
Alright, so yeah, we're gonna go and we're gonna go to a class, because I wanna get to Hogsmeade. I want to buy my wand, and get maybe a new hairstyle. Definitely a new hairstyle.
What was Revelio?
I don't know what that was. Alright, let's pull up the map. Let's see if I remember how to do this. There we go. Defense against the dark arts. No, we want this one so we can get do we have a way we can get there? Fires, okay. Alright. So I wanna. Well, at least the little dots are there. Oh, that's new. Loading. Oh, wow. Yeah, I wanna be able to go to Hogsmeade. Oh, look at that, I'm petting a kitty. And be able to, get all my stuff. What the heck? Ooh, I saw it.
Revelio.
Wyvern Fountain. The fountain of in the Transfiguration Courtyard has a likeness of a wyvern on top and serves as a relaxing place for students to gather. Despite rumors to the contrary, possibly started by Sir Cadogan, this is most assuredly not meant to be a wyvern of Wye. Slain by the lively knight in spite of himself. Alright, so we got that. So, I had a nice little thought last night about the Hogwarts castle. I think it would be cool if somebody did, like, a Hogwarts castle in Planet Coaster that was based off of this Hogwarts castle. So like they would start in like say the Great Hall area and like just start building. Is that Peeves? Oh. Nope. Spare a moment, I can use your help. Duncan.
Trouble are we?
Okay, Duncan's not over there.
Revelio.
Painting of Ilias. This painting depicts the young orphan wizard Ilias, who famously saved his entire village from an army of Dementors and a dark wizard Razidian by conjuring a mouse Patronus. Who's this Duncan guy who needs help?
Ooh, such fun!
Revelio!
I heard a noise. Alright, well. go this way, okay. I do like this, I'm not getting lost. I really wish I knew what Duncan was.
Revelio.
I know I'm supposed to go the other way. There's another cat. People were talking about throwing cats.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Hey, there's another mirror.
Lumos.
Nope. Don't know where that's at. Really came over here for that right there. Let's see.
Revelio.
Chest in there. Ooh, no, more importantly, there's a fire thing. Hey. There's another fire thing in here. Where's here? Ooh. Defense against the Dark Arts classroom.
Revelio.
Professor Fig. As if my schedule wasn't congested enough, the Ministry has charged me with arranging the rather inconvenient arrival of a new student at Hogwarts. A fifth year, if you can believe. Professor Weasley insists that we need an escort and a mentor to help him acclimate ties before term begins. I have assigned the task to you. Please see Professor Weasley for details. Professor Phineas Nigellus Black, Headmaster. You know, I've said it before, I really do like Simon Pegg, and he really, like, had that arrogance about him when he was voice acting. And I think he did a fantastic job. Alright, there's chests upstairs.
Professor Ronan tends to go on a bit. We sometimes have to remind him to finish the lesson.
Some of us don't necessarily want him to get back to the lesson.
Got called on to read out loud in History of Magic.
There's a treasure chest in the stairs.
Off on another adventure, are we?
The goblins,
in
the
werewolves, where were you? In the Goblin Rebellion of 1752!
And by the end of it, the Minister
Rebellion.
Was Albert Boot.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, what fun! I won't say my goodbyes. I shall cheer for the boy who says you're telling
I'm
lies.
I'm not telling lies, Peeves. It was Albert Boot.
No, it wasn't. It was Basil Flack.
Ooh, fight, fight! It's a bold attack. Was the Minister a Boot or the Minister a Flack?
Stop it, Peeves. You'll get us in trouble.
In trouble you will be, but you can't give Peeves a smack. She says it's a Boot.
Got the fire. Couldn't find the treasure chest. Hogwarts is such a maze. All right, let's go in the glass. Wait a minute, there's some upstairs up here. Can I go up here? Nope. Alright. Let's learn Accio. Then we can snatch those pages.
Here! Behind you! There is an open seat here.
Thank you.
Hello, I am Nettie. So you are the new student. Have you met Professor Ronan yet?
Shall we begin? Welcome to year 5 of Charmed. Now, this will be a crucial year in your education on the art of charm work, but I am confident that we will take hold with a passion and rigor requisite of such a challenge. Right, now, everyone, please open your textbooks to page 517. But before we begin, can anyone here tell me the difference between the incantations of the color change and growth charms? Anyone? Anyone? I am afraid it is too late to study now. My, the summer months must have really taken a toll on you all. By the looks of it, you all spent your holidays practicing Obliviate on one another. Do you even remember how to perform a basic summoning charm? Well, it seems that we are in dire need of review. Everyone get into pairs and take positions on opposite sides of the classroom. Now let's put those textbooks to use as the blunt objects you so believe they are, and take turns summoning them out of one another's hands. Only one book will be needed per partnership, Miss Dale. Thank you. Get into place now.
I kind of like this teacher. Shouldn't be too hard. Nailed it.
Akio!
That is not bad.
You are a swift learner. I see a lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just rival Miss Onai here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem to have the basics down, and it is an exceptionally lovely day, I was thinking that we might have ourselves a little excursion outside for a spot of fresh air. After me.
Ooh, going outside. Fantastic. Load screens. Not fantastic. I meant to install this on my SD, but I stuck it on my HD. I think my SD would have made these load screens a little faster. But it was too late after I realized it.
I've always found that fun goes hand in hand with mastery, as I'm sure the Quidditch players amongst us would agree, So, what better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test, right? So why don't we have our newest student start us off,
So his powers are more than just charms, just summoning out of thin air.
Very simply, cast Akio on one of the spheres and relinquish your charm at the last possible moment. Now, think of this like gobstones, if you will. But instead of throwing the marbles out, you are summoning them toward you. The trick is to pull the sphere as far as possible, but not a bit more, or it'll fall, yes? Now, I could keep talking about theory all day, but practice is the best professor. Show us how it's done.
Okay.
Akio!
Very good!
Stay focused!
Okay, too far.
That's it!
Okay, so about the orange.
Splendid!
Yep, mid-orange. Mid-orange sounds good.
Very good. Points to Hufflepuff. But there's certainly no sport in playing without some friendly competition. Miss Onai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge? Come on up. You'll be the blues, just as before, and Miss Onai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Be sharp.
How hard do you think I gotta pull to push yours?
Akio!
Excellent! Good
work, Steve! That is how it's done! Nicely done.
Nice.
Let us make this a bit more interesting, shall we?
I think we are well past interesting at this point.
I'll say.
Enough chatter. Focus now. You will need it. This round settles it all.
Be sharp. There we go. Easy on you now.
Nope, stay, stay, stay.
Oh. Happens to the best of us.
Here we go. That is how it's done. I know everyone is watching, but try not to be nervous.
Akio!
You are doing quite well. Ah, you almost had it. Let us see this.
Very good, both of you. Well done.
Hope there was no prizes for winning.
Class is dismissed. Gather your things on the way out.
Well done back there. You took the loss in stride. Didn't want to go too easy on you. Took me weeks to become proficient with Akio. Took weeks for me to get anything right when I transferred here. It gets easier, I promise.
That's good to hear. It's a lot to take in all at once.
To put it lightly, I remember how I felt when I first arrived. I transferred here from Ouagadou just before my fourth year. My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were halfway around the world at a new school in a new country.
So I noticed that I previously was playing around with the graphics a little, and then the update came out yesterday, and I mean, at least the clothes look better.
Is Ouagadou much bigger than Hogwarts?
Ouagadou School of Magic is the largest wizarding school in the world. So yes, bigger than Hogwarts. But it never seemed intimidating or overwhelming to me. It always felt like home.
Is Ouagadou a castle, like Hogwarts?
Its address is Mountains of the Moon. It is not so much a castle as a beautiful edifice carved out of the mountainside. I remember the first time I saw it, the mist was so thick I could hardly make out anything at all. And then it just materialized before me, this enormous school that seemed to be floating in midair.
Cool.
This may seem an odd question, but is magic the same there as it is here?
Mostly, yes. But I did have to learn how to use a wand when I arrived here. Hardly anyone at Ouagadou uses one.
Wait a minute. So I think I asked a question how Professor Fig was able to Accio without his wand. The Harry Potter books put so much emphasis on having that wand that I didn't think it was possible to do concentrated magic without it. And what I mean by concentrated magic is we see Harry Potter using magic before he turns 11, but that's accidental, so. Yeah, that's awesome.
You can cast spells without a wand.
Oh, yes. I find wandless magic to be much more instinctive, not to mention quite convenient if one is without their wand. I must admit, however, that I am growing quite fond of using a wand. It seems very dramatic.
It's nice to learn about another wizarding school.
Thank you for asking. I do miss Ouagadou, but I am glad to be here at Hogwarts. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
Right.
Of course, you can use Accio on you.
Professor Ronan reminds me of my grandfather. Loads of...
You'd be using it on clothing, to be precise.
After my brother learned the summoning charm, it was constant Accio this, Accio that. Cutlery flying everywhere. Quite unsafe, really.
Okay.
You wanted to speak with me, Professor?
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Well, an outdoor competition wasn't exactly the lesson I was expecting, sir.
What charm is there in the expected? Miss Onai is a talented witch. Take it in stride. One often gains the most from the battles one has lost.
Of course, Professor. It was a challenging match.
Miss Onai is always a fierce competitor, though I sense that she is a bit distracted of late. Now, Professor Weasley has asked that your professors give you instruction outside of the ordinary curriculum. Expect to hear from me soon regarding a special assignment that I am preparing for you.
Perfect. Oh, yeah. Let's see. Means I get a new thing. More gloves. That one's a cloak. that's just the letter I got. Okay. And gear. Alright. Let's wear some gloves. I've got different glasses. Zero defense. No trait applied. But what? Oh, those are the ugliest things I've ever seen. I take that back. Well, you know what? Those are growing on me, but we know that it's all about the gear, right? I don't care. I can't do it. There we go. We'll do those ones. Alright. Let's see what we got here. Got any hats? We do. Okay, I'm starting to feel like I've done this before. Neckwear. No. Do we have any cloaks? Or outfit? Nope. Huh. Well, what do I do with these? Cosmetic applied to gear via the change appearance option in the gear menu. Wait a minute. Where's my... I got the Twitch Drop Merlin cloak yesterday, and I don't see it. I'll have to double check on that. Okay, I'm looking for the appearance. Alright, that's what it said. I'll double check. Cosmetic alterations appear applied to gear via the change appearance option in the gear menu. Okay. Gear menu. Do you see a change appearance? Oh, right there. Oh. So I could wear that janky set of glasses. And then change it. No, we don't want. I definitely don't want that. Can we just go back to the regular glasses, please? Where's my square? There we go. Oh, yeah. I look like I'm from Durmstrang. Look like I'm trying to go to bed, take a nap. Now let's go with the wizarding. Let's go with the wizard hat. Nah, I like this hat. Wait, can I change the appearance to not be wearing a hat? Yeah. I wonder if I have... Can I... No, I like that scarf. Fantastic. Nah. I will take this Hufflepuff. Yeah, there we go. That's nice. I like it. see anything. Alright, we'll do this so that I can see stuff. Oh yeah. Huh. Nope, we're going purple. And then we're going to take that scarf off. Yep. Let's see. See? I like that, but then it takes away the purple. No, we're just going to stick with the regular Hogwarts one. Fantastic. Alright. That's the flame is green.
Hello there. You're the new student, aren't you?
Hello.
Hello. You wanted to speak to me?
Samantha Dale. I've been eager to meet you. You're the student everyone's been whispering about. Hope your first day's going well. You certainly seem to hold your own in charms.
I've been fortunate. Beginner's luck.
My brother William would tell you not to be so humble and to trust your abilities. Then again, he tends to be overconfident in his. Well, better see to my charms homework. I'm afraid I can't count on beginner's luck to impress Professor Onan.
Well, maybe we can start a DA club, and then we can help each other in charms. And now we get to Dark Arts classroom quickly. Ooh, we're going down the stairs. Because I want to get to Hogsmeade, and I have a feeling that to get to Hogsmeade, you gotta complete all these quests. So I believe Professor Fig said we'll get to Hogsmeade. Against dark arts, but there's this
guy. I've always said that
Revelio
broadens the mind.
All right, sneakoscopes? No, not sneakoscopes.
Stupid! Stupid! Is that all you've got? Bombard! Levioso!
Professor Hecate!
Perhaps you'd be good enough to blast each other to pieces in your own time. I get new students every year, but I only have one Hebridean black skull. It was a token from the Great Poacher Raid of 1878. No doubt you've heard of it. Now, you may be asking yourself how an old woman like me single-handedly took out the largest poacher ring in eastern Wales and lived to boast about it. Knowledge. To the wise, age matters very little. Today we will review a spell that has saved me from death at the hands of dark wizards more times than I care to remember. Levioso.
Levioso? A levitation charm?
Levioso! A surprised opponent is a weak opponent. Care to defend yourself, Master Pruitt? No? One thing I've learned as an unspeakable is the value of simplicity, especially in the heat of battle. Now, let's practice what we've just learned, starting with something small.
Unspeakable. That's awesome. Oh, this is a little more difficult. All right, let's go.
Levioso!
So, Levioso is...
Now, let's try something a little larger. Let us begin with the basic cast. See how the dummy deflected your cast? This time, cast Levioso first, then the basic cast. Remember, a surprised opponent...
Levioso!
Well done.
Nice.
Very good, but the best way to practice is by dueling. We'll start with you two. Duelist, take your marks.
Time for a proper Hogwarts welcome.
Now, I want a fair duel, using only Levioso, basic cast, and Protego. You may begin.
Levioso!
Good form.
I know.
It can't be your first duel.
Let's just say I'm a quick learner.
Protego.
Levioso.
Complicates
things. Protego!
I do enjoy life and you.
Not bad for a beginner. You give as good as you get.
I didn't get one.
I put you on the spot, and you rose to the challenge. Points to Hufflepuff.
Thank you, Professor Hecate. Glad to have the opportunity to practice.
If what I've seen today is any indication, we can expect great things from you. I demand excellence from my students. They are capable of achieving it, and they must achieve it. A classroom duel is one thing, but battling dark wizards, or as ever more likely, goblins, is a different kettle of Grindelows entirely.
Understood, Professor.
So, I'd advise you to keep practicing whenever you can. Perhaps Mr. Sallow will have some ideas for you. Again, well done today. I shall reach out soon with additional assignments. All right, that's enough space.
I'd hate to face Professor Hecate in a duel.
Me too.
Oh, I'm not much for dueling. I prefer to keep things friendly.
Huh. Always thought Levioso was for first years. Not anymore.
Revelio.
There's a treasure chest.
If you know the right spells, it's dark wizards that'll fear you, not the other way around.
Upstairs. Wonder if there's anything on her desk. Professor Fig had something on his desk. Can't get in there.
You dueled Sebastian. He's strong competition. Well done.
Nice work.
I enjoyed that.
Well, that duel was quite something. Everyone will be talking about it.
It was certainly good practice.
Practice? It felt more like I was dueling an expert. Sebastian Sallow, by the way. Didn't expect a new student to be so deft with a wand. Then again, perhaps this wasn't your first duel.
In fact, it was. Perhaps I have a knack for it.
Be coy if you like, but I know better. Magic requires intention and talent. You know, you might be a perfect fit for a certain exclusive, unsanctioned dueling organization.
Exclusive and unsanctioned. Count me in.
Excellent. Knew I was right about you. If you want to get the most out of your time at Hogwarts, you're going to need to break the rules now and then. Whether it's joining a secret dueling club, or sneaking into the restricted section of the library, you just have to be clever enough not to get caught.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll keep that in mind.
Good. Pleasure chatting with you. I'm sure I'll see you soon. Perhaps somewhere unsanctioned? We'll see if your performance today was sheer luck, or actual skill. Look for Lucan Brattleby near the clock tower entrance, if you're interested. Till next time.
quests available. Let's see. Crossing crossed wands. That, I think, is a side quest. Till we have something else to do. Other than... I want to go to Hogsmeade. Yeah, that's the one. Alright.
That youngin's now taken.
Oh, loading. There's a fire. Yeah, there is.
What are you up to now?
What about the room, Professor?
I was thinking the same thing, Deke. Perhaps you could help.
Oh, excuse, Deke.
Ah, there you are. I trust your first classes went well?
They did, Professor.
I heard as much from Professors Hecate and Ronan. Seems Professor Fig taught you quite a bit during your brief detour near... What was it you said? Some ruins? I'd wager there's a good deal more to your travels here than what you've told me. Isn't there?
Have you and Professor Fig not discussed my training?
He continues to be reticent about the details, mentioning only a few spells. Revelio, was it? And Lumos?
That's correct, Professor.
I see. Like trying to get a sonnet from a Streeler. Regardless, you must continue to build upon what you've learned. In that regard, I've asked your professors to help hasten your progress with some extra assignments.
Professor Ronan did mention something about that.
In fact, Professor Ronan will meet you outside momentarily to assign your first one. Now, regarding the trip to Hogsmeade I mentioned earlier, we've arranged to replace the supplies lost on your way here, including seeds, potion recipes, and spellcrafts.
Thank you, Professor.
And Mr. Ollivander will connect you with the perfect wand. You've managed your classes well with a borrowed wand, but you'll find the magic you cast with your own wand to be far superior.
Can you tell me more about the potions shop, Professor?
J. Pippin's Potions stocks a wide array of potions ingredients, although they rarely sell recipes. Professor Sharp asked that they have a couple of particular recipes on hand for you.
I've never heard of a spellcraft before, Professor. What is it?
A spellcraft is a recipe of sorts used when conjuring objects. I shall explain more about them when you begin working with transfiguration magic.
There's an Ollivander's in Hogsmeade.
There is. Most people are familiar with the shop in Diagon Alley. We're fortunate to have someone like him nearby. Mr. Ollivander is a genuine craftsman and highly skilled wand maker. I would trust no one else to pair me with a wand.
I'm eager to get to Hogsmeade.
Very well. I'd like you to make your first visit to the village with a classmate. Help you get your bearings. Perhaps Sebastian Sallow or Natsai Oni. I've noticed you spending time with them.
Yeah, let's go with Natty. Sebastian...
I'd like to go with Natty.
Excellent choice. Miss Oni is one of our most talented students. And she knows the area. She'll keep you well clear of any of Victor Rookwood's undesirables en route.
Rookwood?
A rather unsavory local. Best to avoid him and his associates, including his right hand of sorts, Theophilus Harlow, if you can. Once you've finished Professor Ronan's assignment, your friend will meet you at the castle doors. No time to waste. The sooner you complete your work, the sooner you can enjoy a butterbeer at the Three Broomsticks.
Revelio.
So, probably not going to be able to get the Hogsmeade on this. Speak to Professor Ronan to receive your first assignment. Assignments are types of quests given to you by Hogwarts professors that, when completed, reward with new spells. The reward for completing your first assignment will be the Mending Charm, Reparo, which is required to complete other quests. You can track assignments and their progress in the quest menus of your field guide. Okay, as I was saying, probably not this recording. Because we're almost at our hour now. And I think this might take it the rest of the way. Another cat.
Ah, there you are. You have a new spell to teach me, Professor.
Indeed I do, and an exceedingly useful one at that. The Mending Charm, Reparo. Fixes things right up, makes a broken object good as new in the blink of an eye.
It seems as if that might come in handy.
More frequently than one would imagine. As Professor Weasley mentioned, I am not the only one who will be teaching you spells outside of class in an effort to catch you up with your peers. A number of your professors have agreed to do so as well, but first, each shall ask that you complete a few preliminary tasks to hone your magic. I have arranged some for today. See them through and then report back to me. We will have you casting Reparo in no time.
Why must I first complete tasks to learn Reparo?
No lesson or lecture can compare to first-hand experience, and these tasks should provide you with just that. Such experience is invaluable when mastering any new bit of magic.
Or anything, actually.
I'll start on the task right away, Professor.
Okay, collect the flying pages near the broken statue, and collect the flying pages. Alright.
This is the right area. I wonder where the flying page is. Accio! Got it.
Why is there still a dot? Oh, there we go.
A flying page must be around here somewhere. Revelio. Accio.
Only a new student would help me. Might some kind soul help me?
Are you all right?
Don't you know who I am? Zenobia Noak, the girl whom everyone at school hates for no reason.
I'm sorry the other students weren't more friendly.
That's kind of you. I suppose there are a few decent souls here. I wanted to make some new friends, and so I brought my collection down to the common room. My gobstone collection, that is. I was hoping someone would want to play. Are you familiar with gobstones? Little balls, like marbles. Grand game. And if you lose, they spray you with a foul-smelling liquid.
Gobstones? Sounds like a fun challenge.
That's what I tried to tell everyone. People can be so cruel. Just because they're sprayed all over with smelly gobstone spit, it's their own fault for losing. Imelda is one of the worst losers. Everett and Astoria are terrible as well. And now those poor losers have taken my gobstones and hidden them in very high places all over the school.
Rather an overreaction on their part.
I'll say. Anyway, I can't work out how to get them back on my own. I don't think I know the necessary spells yet. I need someone, perhaps a selfless and talented fifth year, to help me.
Well, she's manipulative.
Do you have any suggestions on how to get your gobstones down from their hiding spots?
If I knew that, I'd get them myself. Whoever hid my gobstones that high got up there somehow.
Haven't you any friends at school?
Not really. Natty said hello once, but not a word since.
I'll see what I can do.
I'd appreciate the help. If you do find all of my gobstones, do come and see me again. I'll be back to playing Snake Pit and Jackstone by myself in no time.
Okay. No, I'm still working on pages. Don't change my quests on me. Different wand handles. Reparo. Alright, back to finding that flying page. There it is.
Accio! Brilliant.
Part of me wants to go and find those gobstones. But I'll need the Hogsmeade.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
I bet a broom will do it.
I completed the assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms. Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we? Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic.
Square.
That's it. Very good.
If you would like to practice mending something, have a go with that broken statue in the alcove by the water. It allegedly symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover thought it too accurate and lashed out.
Reparo.
Nicely done. Works like a charm, doesn't it?
Revelio! I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
What to do with that? What if I...
Accio!
No?
Lumos! Levioso! Revelio!
Okay, next quest. Outpost, that opened up. How come I couldn't get like another Hufflepuff? Had to be a 9 Sebastian quests. Okay. Not on the Hogsmeade this time around. That'd be nice. Oh, they are everywhere.
Revelio.
Oh, hello.
Accio. Well, that's one of Zenobia's gobstones. I hardly see what all the fuss is about. Revelio.
Oh. inside.
When I'm in Hogsmeade, I always pay a visit.
Behind the stone door. I'm gonna have to figure out how to do these things. I'm assuming that eventually there will be. Come here. Tutorial on those. Like with the butterfly mirror. Where'd that page just go? It just like disappeared.
Revelio! Accio!
That was it! Half a bottle of flabbergasted leech. Turn clockwise!
Gotcha. Alright. Bad boys. I don't think we're gonna have enough time to catch them all.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Accio!
Oh, yay. Divination's tower.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
That page, and there's a gobstone.
Revelio. Accio.
Sound like they're breaking every time they hit my hand. I want to finish these gobstones up so that next time we're going to Hogsmeade. Spend 10-15 hours just exploring Hogwarts.
Revelio!
Oh, another mirror, huh?
Lumos!
Looks like the Slytherin common room, really.
Revelio! Lumos.
Where were you? Where?
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Oh, and we remember this one.
Leviosa!
Are these the moves? They. Oh man, that is so cool. Oh. I at the top?
Revelio. I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented the blue
hammer. Accio! Revelio!
Trophy room. This room contains the House Cup, Quidditch trophies, dueling trophies, and other awards given at the school. Students who step out of line can find polishing the silver here by hand as a reminder of that value of work.
Akio!
Alright.
Revelio!
Goblet of Fire casket. Ooh, the Goblet of Fire rests within this ancient jewel-encrusted chest. The goblet has served as a means of selecting champions for the Triwizard Tournament since the contest establishment in the late 13th century. Ooh, I wonder, do we get to do the Goblet of Fire? Where is the gobstone?
Revelio.
This set of armor for House Elf is rumored to have been made by a cruel wizard who wanted his elf to protect him in battle. Happily, the wizard was too dense to realize that armor could, in fact, be considered clothing. The moment the elf donned it, he disapparated right out of it, never to be seen again. Fantastic. There it is.
Accio! That's the last of Zenobia's gobstones. I should go and see her.
Herbology, or Hogwarts Herbology Award. In recognition of exemplary skill in the field of herbology, Hogwarts bestows this special award upon 7-year Hufflepuff Mirabelle Garlic. From mandrakes to mistletoe and bobbitubers to bouncing bulbs, her work with Flora has exceeded all expectations. Okay. Now to get back to her. You know, I could use the...
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
But I do like traveling. Yeah. Walking there. I was wondering if I was going to fall off the edge. Did travel far.
I hope you've had more luck than I did tracking down my gobstone.
Hello, Zenobia. I found all your gobstones.
Really? I didn't think it was possible. However did you do it?
Common sense and basic magic.
Well, may I have my gobstones back?
Of course. They are yours, after all.
Oh, how wonderful. I shall dedicate all of my future victories to you. Speaking of which, now that I have all my gobstones back, I wonder if anyone in the common room would be up for a game.
I'm sure they'd be willing to play after the trouble spent getting them back. It's a fine idea.
Isn't it? Oh, we'll have so much fun together laughing as all the losers get sprayed, which won't include me. Very well, off I go. Wish me luck.
Alright, and that is where we're gonna end today. I'll go and save it. And I'll see you back here next time on BT Plays.